Hey, what's going on, you guys? Welcome to Draw It Too. My name is Ramney, and this is another episode of Mini How to Draw. Before we begin, I just want to say a few things. As usual, what you guys need is a pencil, an eraser, any type of white paper, and black ink pen so you can ink afterwards. As you're watching this tutorial, remember that you can pause at any time so you can catch up on your drawings. We all draw at different speeds, so find a pace that works for you and stick to it. And also, if your drawings look a little different than mine, that is completely fine as well. So having said all of that, let's get to the tutorial. For this flash tutorial, we are going to finally have him facing the viewer, so we'll be drawing his front, and we are going to be drawing him. I'm going to be laying my paper in portrait mode for this one, and we're going to try to draw the full body. So let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to draw the head, and I'm going to draw it kind of a little above halfway and a little closer to the left side of the page. That's about right there. And now what we are going to do is we are going to have his face slightly tilted, okay? So we're going to, first let's draw the line that goes down the middle of his face. That's the center line. And we are going to follow that center line along the sides of his face here. And then we're going to draw a pretty sharp chin, just like that. Grant Gustin does have a pretty narrow chin compared to the top of his head. So that's how it starts. Now let's get the shape of the body first before we get into the little details. So there's the initial part. Try to draw this lightly so that you don't have to erase too hard later on. I'm just going to create the area where I'm going to put the ears. No idea where it's going to be yet, but we're just going to leave it there for now. Now let's draw a line going from the chin. Kind of, this is the center line going down his torso, and it's slightly, whereas this kind of goes this way, we're going to slightly change this direction a little bit this way. So that's how it's going to be. Okay. And just below it, right below the chin, right around here is where we're going to have the chest. So I'm just going to create this wide curve. It's almost like a V. It goes like that. Okay. From here, I'm just going to draw a line going out this way. And from here, a line going out this way. Looks a little funny right now, but that's where the chest is going to go. And then the chest kind of does this, like that. So it's a little funny to start off like that, but it just gives you a general idea of how big this body is going to be below his head. Because the head is, because he's leaning forward, the head's going to be big, and the body's going to be pretty tiny. So I'm just drawing this to reflect that. Right around here, we're going to draw a line going out like that. And then the shoulder muscle kind of just does a little curve like this. Goes out like that. From here, I'm just going to draw a little tip. So I just create this shoulder right here, like that. Now, let's go over to this side. Let's go over here, and we're going to create the shoulder muscle going like that, and to the side of the head here, like this. And then, well, let's start over here, and we're actually going to draw a straight line going up, a straight-ish line going out like that. That's going to be the side, or like the side of the arm. Okay, here's where the bicep muscle is. Here's the tricep. We're going to start right here. It goes out like that. And then slightly changes directions, and it keeps going straight. And then it will find an elbow right around there. Okay, now let's go back over here. I'm going to draw a little line like that. That's going to be for the back, the side. From here, I draw a line going out like this, and then up again like that. And then from here, let's kind of draw in the bicep, and it kind of goes like this. Okay, now the bicep is actually going to go this way as well. So here's the bicep muscle. Okay, from here, we're going to draw a line that goes this way towards the head. So let me straighten my paper first. And we're going to find where we're going to put the hand first. So here's where I want you to put the hand. Right around here, on the side of the head. Right, kind of just below the top of the head here. Right here is where we're going to put the thumb. So here's a small little line. Goes down about that much and goes in and then down again. Okay, at this point you should be above the shoulder muscle. From here goes like this. And then goes up. And then another curve like that. So it kind of looks like a butt right here. And then it just goes, this one goes straight up. So it looks like he's making this karate chop, which is what he's doing when he's running. So this goes, when it goes up, it sort of goes closer. It kind of narrows. It gets narrower at the top here. Okay, so from the top of the thumb, we go straight up again, and then it starts to go like this. And that's where we're gonna put the hand. Let's complete the thumb down and then out towards this line. And then from here, just a curve going this way and then towards the thumb and then another line going across. All right, and this is where we're gonna put the fingers. So let's kind of divide that into individual fingers and we'll fix it later on. Okay, here's one, here's another one. And this one, you wanna make sure that it's the size of a finger and it's lower, so it goes right around here. So there's the hand. And now what you wanna do is you wanna connect the hand to this point right here that we did. So from here, here's the wrist, okay? And you want it to connect to here, just like that, okay? Extend, elbow, another short line, and then here, connects like that, okay? So it essentially covers the bicep area, which is what we intended to do anyway. Okay, now let's go over here. Let's start right around here, and let's start working in the torso. So one short little line here, and one over here. This one goes in slightly like that, and then goes back out. Now this one, same thing, goes in, goes down a little bit, and then sort of comes out again. Okay, now we gotta find the belt and the area where his jacket sort of ends. So from here, we're just gonna angle two lines going down, meeting at this center point right here. So that's about a good size right there. As you do this, just make sure that you got the proportions right. Just checking to make sure that I got everything right. And like the way that I'm doing it, I'm darkening a lot of the lines, which I really shouldn't because it'll make it hard to erase later on. But do try your best to make those lines as light as you can. All right, let's continue this line going down this way. We're gonna draw a little crotch area right here, okay? From here, a little line going out like that. And now we're gonna draw the thigh. And the thigh is, well, let's start over here. It sort of goes out this way. Ignore this line right now. It actually goes out like this. So we're gonna go out this way and then down like that. And you want the thigh to be about a little bit bigger than, see, from here to here. You want it to be a little bigger than that. So you want it to go right around here. And you wanna just create this curve like that. And then over here, here's the knee. And then from the knee, we bring our line up. It's narrower here and it gets wider as you reach the top. Just like that. Right now, we're gonna find a point right here. We're gonna draw the foot from there. So here's the heel. It goes angles like that. Out and in again. You want to end it right around here so that the knee and the foot are in the same area, like it ends off in the same plane. Okay, curved line across and then line going up. Okay, now from here we're just going to draw a little bit of the calf muscle, goes out like this, like that. So that's how we want that. We'll fix that up later on once we figure out the proportions for the rest of the body. Let's go back over here. Now this should be very narrow. Okay, so from here, right around here, we're gonna start closing it in. So here's the foot that's closer to the body, so that's why it's big. But over here, it's the leg that's further away from the body, so it is a lot smaller. Okay, so here's the thigh. I'm gonna draw just a rectangle for now for the knees. And then on the side here, two lines going out, two lines going in. Okay, here's the calf muscle right there. It gets really tiny. And here are the ankles. It's just two little, they look like ears to me. Okay, this one goes out and then angles like this and then a straight line. This goes back like that. So essentially you've got the knee, this foot and this foot kind of on the same plane, but it does give the indication that he is running. Once we erase this line, it should look like he's running. Okay, now lastly, let's draw the other arm. From here now, goes out like this, and straight like that. Okay, find about this big. That's how you want that elbow. You want to create that elbow, and here's the forearm. It's narrower, of course. And I'm going to create that line right there, and another line right here. That's for the glove. And right here, line going out, and then going straight like this. Another line, this one goes straight like that. And then from here, I'm going like this. So as you can see, it's sort of starting to shape that hand, and he's also giving that judo chop hand similar to this. Okay, so there's the general shape for the flash. Now, all you have to do is make sure that you got the proportions right, make sure that you got your lines nice, and you don't want anything too big or too small. And once you do that, you can start getting into the details. Zooming in on the face now, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to erase the bottom of that first circle that we did. We don't really need that anymore. And now let's start to figure out how to draw Grant Gustin's face. And now, like I usually say, don't worry about making your face look like the actor's, because that's not what we're going for here. We're trying to just draw the character and not the actor, right? So just reshaping things, and I'm making it slightly bigger like that. All right, so let's start with the nose and the chin, because, well, for me, I guess it's better to place them now. And I think the chin, we're gonna have a chin strap. It kind of goes right here. Here's the bottom of the mouth, and here's kind of where I want the mouth to be. Here's that little dip below in between the nose and the mouth there. And then here's the bottom of the nose, and I'm gonna create a V shape for now. And right above that is right there. And that's where I want the mask to kind of start taking shape. So I did it in reverse. There's really no problem if you do it the other way. So here's where the mask goes over the bridge of the nose here. And it goes like this, and then goes up again here and here. Okay, that goes down and that goes down, but doesn't quite touch the chin. Or doesn't touch the jaw. It sort of goes down the jaw like this, and like this to the chin, to the chin strap. Okay, now here's just shaping the nose a little bit. And then now we're going to kind of give him a bit of a smirk. We want to make him smile a little bit. So just draw two edges right there, the bottom of that. And now let's start to shape the eyes. So from here, I create a line from here. It's going from there to there. And right here is where the bridge of the nose is gonna be. It's also where I'm going to draw the eye holes, I guess you could call them. Down this way, curves up, just like that. Okay, same thing over here, across the top. Right here, curves. Take your time on this one and make sure that those eye holes are roughly the same shape and size and distance from each other. And like I said, feel free to pause the video if you need to. And as you guys notice, I keep the top line straight and the bottom line curved. Now let's draw the eye inside. The eye is sort of going to go, it's going to follow this same top line. I'm going to start right here, go down like this. And then I just draw a little line like that to close it. Same thing over here now. Goes down this way. Like that. And again, you want to make sure that you draw this symmetrically. Now let's draw the pupils, and I draw them as half circles that touch the top of the eye. Okay, and then another circle inside. There you go. Now let's give him a bit of a scowl. So let's start to curve this in more like this, and let's give him that two lines right there. And then just small line above, go like that and like that. Reshape the nose here. I want it a little bit more wide. And there you go. I'm gonna make the top of his head a little bit bigger. Okay, and then from here, draw two lines going this way, like from the tip of the, like where the eye hole is, going straight up, and then goes down again, there and there, and then it goes to the top of the head, there and there. So there you go. That's the Flash's helmet. I'm just going to reshape the jaw here. Make this little line right here just to indicate the top of the head and the forehead. So just a couple of lines right there. Now right here, okay, you see where you've got this line right here? Right across right here, you want to start creating the earpiece, and it goes like that. Okay, so same thing over here. From here, just make your way to the side of the face and start making your earpiece about that big from the face. Now draw a line from here going straight up, about that big. And you want to do the same on this side, just erasing part of the arm so you can see, like that. So it looks like antenna for now. And then from here, it makes this really narrow upside down V. Same thing here, goes like that. Okay, now from here, a line like this, and then a line going down. Same thing here, line going up, and then line going down. And then from here now, I curve it slightly and make this shape like that. Same thing here, it goes like that. And then from here, I just make a line from there, going down like that. So that's just a stylized W on the sides of his head. Of course, it's hard to see because of the way his head is angled. He's facing us, of course. And there you go. Now let's work on his torso now. And let's start with the neck piece. It's a circle that sort of goes around. So here's that part of the neck piece right here. And you see a little bit over here as well. Looks like that. Okay. Now let's draw the Flash emblem, and it's going to be an oval that sits right where his chest line meets the center. He looks like that. What you want to do is you want to draw another oval beneath it, or inside of it. So that looks like that. And now from here, we're going to make our way to there. Okay, one, two, three, and then out again. So from here to here, and you make a little Z, and then it goes back out. And then here we'll do the same thing from here to here, make a little Z, like that, and then it goes back out. Now, here we're going to reinforce, we're going to make that line darker. And here as well, we're going to make that line darker. This is the line that sort of divides the chest with the shoulder. That's a pretty distinct thing on the Flash's costume. Here we've got the Velcro right here. So line going down the center and then to the left of it, another line going down. And then we're just gonna create the division where his chest actually ends. So that's where his chest should go. We're just gonna draw like that. All right, now let's draw the belt. So let's go down here and about this far up, we create this wide V again. And this becomes the belt buckle that the Flash wears, like that. And then we just draw a little bit below the tip here, just there. Make that go all the way to the sides. Here again. So it looks like that. Now, from here, actually, let's start right here and right here. What we're going to do is we're going to draw two lines that go to this tip and this tip right here. Okay, those are ab lines, like that's where the line of abs are supposed to go. But his jacket is loose enough that you don't really see the abs. So here, let's go this way and then down like that. And over here, this way and then down. So this is the line you actually want to keep right there. Now on the side, here's a little lightning motif. It goes up, down, and then it follows this curve right here. And then right here, let's do another zigzag. One, two, and then down like that. Okay, now over here, it goes up and then it just goes down like that. So right there. And then right here, let's do the same zigzag. One, two, three, just like that. All right, now he's got some lightning patterns right here on the vowel, it just looks like a W. And you want the end of the W to sort of follow this line right here, just like that. So here's the other W, right there. Make this a little bit wider. There you go. So that's the costume. Let's go to the arms before we go with the legs. Okay, let's start over here. You want to draw a line going down here. Let's erase the shoulder line a little bit. Don't want to give it too much definition. Okay, it goes like that. And erase some of this. We want this line to go, just goes over the shoulder down like that. Okay, here's the bicep line. But what we want is we want this to go this way. Okay. Let's give this some definition, more of the bicep line. Actually, I'm going to make this one a little bit less prominent. Okay, right here, I'm going to draw that line right there. And of course, the tricep muscle. Now let's go over here and let's figure out the glove. It actually goes out like that. This is actually part of the jacket and it's not the glove just yet. From here, we're gonna draw a band that goes across the forearm like that so that it creates like these gauntlet looking things. Okay, this one extends out. This one also extends out. And then right here, he's got some padding on the elbow. I'm gonna draw two lines, one, two right there. And then I draw the rest of the elbow like that. Okay, and then I'm just gonna draw a line going right here. Just a seam right there. Okay, now right here, I'm just gonna draw a couple of lines going across the thumb right there. And I'm gonna start shaping that thumb nicely like that. And over here goes that. Okay, here's the palm. And then let's start shaping the fingers. Let's start with the pinky first. Goes like that. Ring finger. The middle finger right here. And then the index or the pointer finger, like that. Okay, so that's good. We've got pretty much got this done. Let's go on this side now. Let's reshape the shoulder. Here's the shoulder part, but what we want to do is we want to find this line right here that cuts along the bicep, and then it goes back this way. Okay, shape the bicep. Draw a little bit of a dip right there. Now shape the tricep as well. Goes like that. Here's the gauntlet part, the same as this right here. Okay, here's the thumb. We actually want the thumb to come out like this. And now we've got fingers. We won't draw all the fingers for this one, so maybe we'll just draw the middle finger and the index finger. That's all you get to see. So it just looks like that. All right, so that's that. Now let's start working on the crotch and let's start working on the legs. Just gonna shape these a little bit better, make them look a little bit nicer before we do anything. So what I'm actually gonna raise this, the thigh up a little bit so that it's not the same plane as the legs, the feet. But that's just, I mean, that's just a choice that I make. You guys don't have to do that. All right, so we've got that. Let's start with the crotch. It's got two lines, one going down the middle and then one going down on the side here. And I'm kind of leaning them this way because of the way that the fabric is going to fold over here. So here's where the fabric is folding because he's got his leg bent. And right here, there's no fabric folding. We're gonna start right here. Draw a small little line like this and draw a line going across or just going from the top going down following the same curve, and then right here it sort of goes this way and then it goes down to the tip right here. So again, this is part of that lightning motif that he's got all over his costume. So there's that lightning shape going down the side of his leg. And then we do the same thing right here. Oh, I forgot to mention that, imagine this sort of extends going down. That's what that does. And same thing here, this line right here extends down, and that's where you want to start that lightning. So this time around, it goes down this way, goes up again, and then goes down towards the knee. But this time around, you see a little bit of the side right here. It's just different fabric on the Flash's costume. Okay, but on this side, you don't really get to see this part of it. Right, let's go over here. Let's add some knee pads. I'm gonna draw two lines like this, one, two, and then one more here, one more line like that, one, two, and it just sort of goes over his knee like this. And then now follow that line. Here's the cut for the boot, the top of the boot there. There you go. And then right here, I'm gonna draw a line like this from here going like that. And here's the yellow part of his red boot. Kind of looks like that. Okay, now over here, remember this rectangle that we did that actually creates the knee pad, and I'm going to divide that into four. So one, two, three, four. Looks like that. Okay, here's the top of the boot there. And then I create the rectangle from here to here, a really narrow one. And then I just draw some vertical lines going across. And that's the yellow part of his boot. Okay, so that's pretty much the gist of it. It's not that hard because the Flash's costume is relatively easy to draw, and it's simple in comparison to some of the speedsters that we have in the TV show. And there you go, you guys. That is it. That is how you draw the Flash from the CW's The Flash. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. And yeah, it is. I intended to replace my older one, which is kind of outdated now. I'm kind of embarrassed for that one. So yes, I hope that this is a good enough replacement for that drawing.
And that is all the time that we have. Thank you for watching this video to the very end. If you are proud of your drawings, I would love to see it. So please go to the Google Plus community and post your artwork there for all of us to enjoy. If you are curious about the equipment that I use to do my tutorials or to make my videos, I have links to those in the description below. Clicking on those links helps to ensure that content creators like myself are supported so that we can continue making good stuff like this for you guys free of charge. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you guys subscribe. Here in this channel, I show you how to draw your favorite characters in easy to follow, simple step-by-step instructions. So if you guys do like what you see, please hit that subscribe button below this video. And if you guys feel like being awesome and you want to support this channel even more, I have a support button that is on the main page of my channel. I have merchandise for sale, such as this shirt right here and this mug right here. Links to those in the description. Anyway, if you guys did enjoy this tutorial, it would help me a great deal if you guys liked this video, commented below, or shared this video with your friends in social media. And speaking of social media, don't forget you guys can find me on Facebook, Instagram, Google+, and on my website, drawitoo.com, where you can download a coloring page of this tutorial and my other tutorials in this channel. Again, links below. Finally, thank you once again, and as always, stay tuned for more so you can learn to draw too. I'll see you guys in my next video.